gone. She'd only been with Younique for 2 weeks, and so she really couldn't answer any questions for me. I had her on speakerphone, my husband was listening, and I said, "Babe, what do you think? What should I do?" I ran from direct sales. It was, you know, schemes and, you know, take your money and run kind of stuff. And so he said, "Whatever you think." And so I did what I do. I prayed about it, and I felt like I heard the Lord say, "Get in and get in now." So I joined Younique, having never bought a product. I didn't know anything about the company. I went purely on what I felt in my spirit that I needed to do. So I joined Younique and knew nothing about this foundation or about the mission of the company. How many of you have heard Derek's story about why the Younique Foundation was started? Homework for those of you who could not raise your hands. Before next week is over, I want you to go to YouTube and I want you to find Derek's story, because you cannot produce your maximum potential unless you know why this company was started. You need to watch that. I think it needs to be a requirement for every new presenter to watch that. So I attended convention in that next August, so like 9 months later. And at the end of that, Derek was talking about the Younique Foundation. They were about to launch it, and Shalane came on the stage and began to talk. And I was a mess. I could not contain myself. I was embarrassed, to be honest with you. And I'm going to cry again just thinking about it. But I had no idea why I was with Younique. I had no idea why I was here. I promoted pretty quickly through the ranks to green status, and the money was great, but that wasn't the drawing card for me. And when I heard about the Younique Foundation, something clicked with me, and I knew I'd found my why for being with Younique. So they told us that we could begin applying that August to the Younique Foundation, and honestly, I experienced childhood sexual abuse as a child, but I am an ordained minister and have done lots of work in my journey toward healing. I wanted to apply because I'm the type of person that if I'm going to tell you that something is working or that we're doing something as a company, I wanted to know what we were doing. I went because I was nosy, can I just be honest? So I applied really thinking to myself, I don't need this. There's nothing they're going to, I've done the work. There's nothing that they're going to be able to show me. And as a lot of survivors of childhood sexual abuse do, I told myself my story is not as bad as other people. Somebody else deserves that spot more than I do. And I was shocked when I arrived on the weekend with the other 9 ladies that were there. And we sat around and all 9 of them said, "I feel guilty for being here because I feel like I've taken up a spot that someone else deserves to have." So let's dispel that myth, sister. Statistics say that 1 in 4 women have been sexually abused before the age of 18, and that's only those who are reported. Less than 30% are actually reported. So that tells me that under the sound of my voice, I'm speaking to other survivors as well. And I'm telling you, don't you believe the lie that you don't need it or that someone else deserves it more than you. You deserve to be healthy.
Yes, ma'am.
So I attended the retreat. My weekend was weekend number 8. I jokingly tell people that the first 100 people that went through the week, we were guinea pigs, and we deserved to go back again. I hope Shalane hears this. It was an awesome, awesome experience for me. And just as Shalane shared, I was fearful. I was afraid of, you know, what is this going to be about? They didn't really give us a lot of details at that time. I wondered, what is it going to feel like when I walk into the room and everybody knows what happened to me? I will tell you this. There is never at any point that they will ask you your story if you or someone that you love attends the retreat. Even when you fill out the application, it's very basic. They're going to ask you your contact information. But at no point will anybody from the Younique Foundation ask you to tell your story. Now, throughout the retreat, there are opportunities where you can share if you want to, but no one will ever ask you to share your story or do anything that makes you feel uncomfortable. I was completely floored by what happened that week in my life. 15 minutes ago, I messaged the 9 women who were with me that week, and I said, "I'm about to share about our weekend. They're going to be praying for you, and they're going to be praying for me as we're speaking." 2 years later, I'm still very, very connected with the women. years, we walked away as lifetime friends and sisters. It's incredible. And as I said, I've done a lot of work as a minister. I've gone through lots of classes and been in prayer and done lots of work. But the way that the information is presented at the Younique Foundation, the atmosphere in which it's presented, is absolutely astounding. So when I had the opportunity to come and stand before you ladies today, I knew that I had to, because I want you to know you are making a difference. I saw it, I see it, I hear it. I understand now that a part of my why for being a part of Younique is because I am a voice for the Younique Foundation and the Younique Foundation Retreat. The other 9 ladies who attended the weekend with me have never come forward and been able to share that they were on that weekend or that week with me. I am in a place in my healing where I feel like that it's my mission to tell people I was there. Because it's easy when we say 1 in 4 women have been sexually abused before the age of 18 to look at that as a number. But when I stand before you today, 1 in 4 women becomes a name and a face and a curl. You need to know that this is a real statistic. 90% of the abusers of children are people that they know. This is happening in our world. We can't let it stay a number.
That's right.
We have to understand that it's people, it's our sisters, it's our children, and we have to be the voice. We have to carry the mission forward. So I'm giving you some more homework. I want you this week to share some kind of awareness on your Facebook page. Go to the Younique Foundation Facebook page.
That's right.
Go to the YouniqueFoundation.org and find a post, find information, and bring awareness. I believe that we as presenters, we need to be talking about this mission a lot more than we do. We need to make it a part of everything that we do in our country. Person that attended that week, but if I can tell a room full of 500 or however many women that are here that we're making a difference, and I can encourage you or inspire you in some way to go out and to speak to those people that are in your network, it won't be long before we can cover the earth with the message that this should not happen to our children, and that if it did happen to you or someone you love, that there's hope and there's healing.
That's
and
right.
You don't have to continue.
That's right.
The way that you're continuing. You can have healing.
That's right.
Through the Younique Foundation. It's incredible the difference we're making. One more thing I want you to do. I want you to do a little experiment with me, okay? I want everybody to take their hand and put it in their lap, okay? Just put your hand palm up in your lap. Now I want you to stare at your hand, okay? I want you to think about this past week, because we know that we're all perfectly imperfect. I want you to think about some things that have weighed heavily on your mind this week. Some problems, some stress, something negative, just for a minute. I know we go positive at Younique, but for just a minute, I want you to focus on a problem that you've had. Stare at your hand and think about that, okay? Everybody doing that. Okay, look up here at me. I just held my fingers up above my head, and I had a certain number of fingers that I was holding up. Can anybody tell me how many fingers I held up? No? Do you know why you couldn't see what I was doing with my hand? Because you were too consumed at looking at your hand. If we are so focused on our businesses, building our businesses, getting to the next color,
that's
making
right.
sure that we have the right PRS, making sure that we add the
that's
right,
right.
presenters, and we are so focused on where we are in our business, we will miss the fact that there are women all around us that need us to see that they need
that's right.
this makeup. They need the vision of this company.
That's right.
Incredible women who have inspired me, given me ideas and given me encouragement and validation in some things that I was already doing. But one thing I want you to take away is that we have a mission and we are obligated. Derek and Shalane and Melanie started this company for a reason, and it's more than just so that we can,
that's right.
we can have wealth in our pocketbooks. That's a big part of it, and I'm thankful for it.
Yes, ma'am. Prosperity is the byproduct of obedience.
But it's about bringing health and wholeness to
that's
women.
Right.
And listen, if you are a Younique presenter that is here today and you are a survivor, I want to encourage you, do whatever it takes to get healthy and whole, because you can't adequately live out the mission of this company unless you are healthy and whole yourself. A woman who is broken can't help other women who are broken until somehow she's able to find wholeness in herself.
That's right.
The Younique Foundation is doing that, y'all. And I'm super proud to be a voice for this company.
Yes.
And for what we're doing. We're making a difference. Thank you.
Yes.